This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
So July 4th means a great display of pride as we watch Americans shovel soggy hot dogs into their mouths. The Nathan's hot dog eating contest.
Yeah.
Nothing makes me more proud. There was a thing this year. I didn't know if it's always been a part. There's the lemonade chugging contest.
No,
we'll get to that.
Yeah, I don't know if it's been a new thing or not, but that's, like I said, disgusting.
Ugh.
Yeah, I had a really hard time watching it, but I plowed right through it. So here we go. We do have a new champ because, of course, Joey Chestnut couldn't compete in the hot dog.
Oh, yeah, contest. That's right. There's a big to-do.
What a time to be alive. What a time to be alive.
And the winner is Patrick Bertoletti. Chicago, Illinois.
It was all focused today. No mohawk, just hot water. And I wasn't going to stop eating until the job was done.
Good for you, buddy.
How many did he eat?
58 dogs.
And how long does it say?
Because
Joey Chestnut ate 57 hot dogs in 5 minutes after the Nathan's ban.
He surpassed his personal best of 55 dogs in 10 minutes.
In 10 minutes, Joey Chestnut, he ate 57 hot dogs. And this is just like after that, as a, like, you know what? Let me show you how it's done.
Mm-hmm.
Here's your champion, and he's not even the best.
So, well, this guy did 58. So.
Right, but how fast?
I'm assuming in 10 minutes.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. He ate 57 hot dogs, Joey Chestnut, in 5 minutes.
Okay.
So he's just all showing right. It up.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, it's Joey Chestnut. He's the greatest that's ever been, I guess. It's
Do you
whatever.
Think that was what it was? I don't know the details behind why he was banned.
Oh.
I was looking
because
for
because he is a spokesperson for Impossible Foods.
Oh.
So that apparently when it gets major league eating, they say it when it gets the brand exclusivity rules for the competition.
Okay, so I thought maybe they were just trying to get rid of him so they could have a new champion.
Nah.
Tired of him being Tom Brady.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was wondering about that too. But there's going to be another hot dog eating contest on Netflix on Labor Day. Which is September 2nd. And it's going to be Chestnut versus Kobayashi. You know that, right?
No.
Unfinished beef.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So that'll reunite rivals for the first time since 2009.
It's like the Clash of the Titans there.
In a five hot dog sudden death beat off. I mean,
yeah. Oh, man, I just had a hot dog. I had Doyle's Dogs.
Yeah.
In Lake Mills just recently.
Yeah.
Pretty damn good.
Yeah, I've never been there. I've always wanted to go.
Me too. And then finally, I did it, and it was, they had a big old half, fourth pounder.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it was pretty awesome.
Dude.
Pretty damn good. I'd say it was close to the movie theater ones, you know?
Oh, man. I love tube meat.
Oh, it's good. Let me ask you this. If you had to, not even compete, how many hot dogs you think you could just take down? Those big, you know, I guess the ones they have are just the normal size ones, right?
I don't know that I could do a whole one.
What?
Like those big, yeah.
Really?
Not anymore, dude. There's no way. I've been...
At your peak. Hunger, physicality.
Because I just... I have problems now. There's like regret.
I know every time I eat something, I feel like, you're a piece of snit, man.
Well, it's not even that. It's that... I don't know if it's the nitrates or what's going on
yeah.
in there, but like I'll be burping it up for like 12 hours. So like I just know there's like I'm gonna pay for this.
You ever take just Tums with it? You get acid refluxy?
No, not even that. It's
no.
just I just burp up the friggin' hot dog for like 12 hours. And it's not pleasant.
Yeah. I've been around it.
Yeah, I know. And I'm like, I'm sorry about that.
I'd rather you like, fart, dude.
Dude, it's bad. It's not fun. I know. And
oh, that meat smell.
Dude, yeah, I know. It's bad. I told you. Okay. So.
Neither, not even one, huh? Not off to a good start.
I know. Well, and I love hot dogs. The last one too. I had was at the Black Bear Inn.
Oh, Cottage Grove?
Yeah. They've got a good hot dog, but like yeah. I said, then 12 hours later, I'm making out with my lady, and I'm like, I am so sorry.
Oh, no. What did she do?
Well, it's not like I burped into her mouth.
Oh, my God.
But I was like, dude, I need to leave the room for a second. Like, I can't. I need to go burp this away for a bit.
That's... Okay, I get the appeal of kissing, but as I got older, I think kissing's like, you know what I mean?
It's like, man, I love kissing.
But then I don't know if I've seen too much stuff in people's mouths or that. Yeah. You get that. Unless they have like good dental hygiene. I'm no way. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Just the thought of just there being that like white stuff. It looks like their teeth are wearing sweaters.
Oh, no.
You know what I mean? That,
All right, so... we have the lemonade drinking contest.
We've got another competition. I know, Rich, it's one of your favorites. It is the Nathan's Lemonade Chugging Competition, which is a shorter competition. It's only about a minute. And Eric Badlands Booker, he's dominated for years. Let's send it down now to your much more charming but older brother, George Shea.
And now, my friends, it is time for the Chugging Championship of the World. Reigning champion Badlands Booker, 23.8 seconds for a gallon of Nathan's lemonade. But we will see if that record is broken here today. Count it down with me from 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, they have like a giant mason jar. He is just going to town. He's like, it's like a wave.
That is
the dude next to him.
Badlands in a zone here. I don't know the...
The dude to
like
his right is a blonde guy with a mohawk. I guess his name is Airsoft Fatty.
He looks kind of like Napoleon Dynamite.
Oh, my God. That dude
Ladies
just
and gentlemen,
went to town.
Badlands Booker, a new world record.
That's a big...
21 seconds, a new world record. 1 gallon of Nathan's famous lemonade. The once and future champion of the world, Badlands Booker.
Everybody's excited. Everybody's Dude. Clapping. But then.
Oh, my God.
Then it goes bad. Because Airsoft Fatty, as dude, Badlands Booker is getting the belt.
Oh,
Airsoft
no.
Fatty is standing there. And again, just reflect. It's July 4th. We're proud to be in America.
Oh, no.
Projectile vomiting on to the front row. He doesn't even move. He's just standing at the table, and he just projectiles right into the front row. Not once. There it is again. And the security guard behind him is like, oh, no.
Somebody's cleaning that. Booker's just got his belt up
Booker's
there.
Booker's got his belt. He's like, oh. And he's like, huh.
He just walks away from him. All right, dude. Oh, he taps him with the shoulder.
He's like, let's get out
Come
of
on,
here.
Come on, dude.
Yeah, okay.
Your mohawk ain't saving you. That's gross.
And he only chugged, I mean, that's so it's a gallon. He only chugged like a, not even a, a fifth of it, a quarter of it maybe. Oh, bro. So
that
bad.
Is net. You know, isn't drinking like that much water or any sort of liquid like dangerous?
I don't. Well, a gallon, I think you're fine, but
you can't. Amount of water that could be toxic to the body is says drink more than a liter of water per hour for several hours, or replacing electrolytes could
yeah.
be risky.
Yeah, for several hours, you got to do it.
Okay, so it's but, not like you could pound. You could pound a gallon. That, think about how much that is, though.
It's a lot.
Your body has to expand that much? Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
And then to...
Suddenly, Bartis opened his mouth. And before Bill Travis knew it, he was covered with 5 pies worth of used blueberries. The women in the audience screamed. Boss man Bob Cormier took one look at Bill Travis and barfed on Principal Wiggins. Principal Wiggins barfed on a lumberjack that was sitting next to him. Mayor Grundy barfed on his wife's tits. But when the smell hit the crowd, that's when my ass plan really started to work. Girlfriends barfed on boyfriends. Kids barfed on their parents. A fat lady barfed in her purse. The Donnelly twins barfed on each other. And the women's auxiliary barfed all over the benevolent order of antelopes.
I forgot how good that scene is.
I know, totally. The movie's great.
Yeah.
That's Stephen King.
Yep.
That was, by the way, I'm not eating. You're helping me lose weight because I'll remember that. I don't know what it is. I don't like vomit, dude. Vomit bothers me.
I was watching that lemonade chugging contest, and it was already hard enough to watch that dude. I don't know why it was hard to watch him chug that gallon of lemonade, but it was.
It's just the sweetness and the sourness of it.
And it was like the motion of it all. I was like, then that guy puking on the crowd is like, oh, for Christ's sake.
Oh, man. I feel sick.
And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you.
I think that's enough for one break. I'm not going to bring up the dude that put fireworks on his head in the same break. I just can't. It might be too much.
A little bit much.
You know?
The yak is.
Oh, no.
I don't think I've had a whole anything of lemonade before.
I love the Crystal Light lemonade. I really do. It's tasty.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not going to lie. And I mean, who does the lemonade at the fair is great, but it's so.
Yeah.
They
put so
that's much. A freaking once a year. You share it with somebody else because you can feel your goddamn sugars raising through the friggin' roof.
Yeah.
So you know, kind of thing. Yeah.
A&W root beer. I just did that.
Yeah.
You can only have one of those every third moon because it's too much. You know, it'd be okay if you just had just the lemons in water. You know, squeeze all lemon, a little bit of juice, stuff like that. But it's all the stuff they put in it.
Yeah.
I think like those other teas, those mass-produced ones, and I just can't do those hard iced teas, any of the iced teas that are lemonade. Sorry.
Yeah.
Just they're too much. It's just too sugary, and it feels like I'm gonna.
I know. Listen to us. We're a bunch of babies. Can't eat hot dogs anymore.
Well, hold on now. I could put down some hot dogs.
Oh my God! Did you see that video I posted on Angie's timeline? There was this chick. She was swallowing hot dogs whole, like 30 of them.
What?
Yes, I couldn't watch the whole thing.
How does that get?
What happened in my news feed over the weekend? I'm just reflecting now. It's like, how did all of this end up in my news feed?
That's the girl that has all... I have so many guy friends.
Dude, I know. Yeah. Well, it started with this chick... taking down a whole freaking pickle. It's bad. Like a big, gigantic... Oh, it's hard.
Like a cucumber?
Yeah.
She swallowed. That's dangerous.
Yeah, it's bad. I know. But the hot dog one, I couldn't watch it all. And
was she hot?
Yeah. And she had to like bounce around to like adjust where the hot dogs were landing at. It's.
She had to move around to shift them in her stomach. Her stomach's like a giant pack of hot dogs. Ugh.
The internet has ruined us, everybody.
How many did she swallow? Did you know?
I couldn't watch the whole thing because I started getting the pre.
Does she have like dark hair?
Yeah.
Is this it right here?
I started getting the pre pukey. Yeah.
Oh, she's. Oh, God.
Yeah. She like literally.
They're 10 seconds. It's like one. So yeah. One full swallow right there.
Oh, my God. I'm going to throw my coffee. She just. She just like tosses them
here,
down her
you
throat.
You could hear
hole.
It here. If maybe she could hear that.
Is there
the sound? Nope. Oh yeah. Ugh. She just sounds like that song for Two Girls, One Cup. Dude, she's like, And they're cans of hot dogs.
People, relax.
What a complete waste.
We are killing it online. Have you guys checked the comments?
Of cyberspace.
Smoke That Skin Wagon says, you guys are killing it.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
We're internet sensations.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a new study going on.
What?
And it's just to the real reason women masturbate and how often they're performing it.
Okay.
So women masturbate in order to relieve stress. Not because they're fueled by rabid sexual fantasies. Frisky research from the new Switzerland survey revealed. The study surveyed 370 women aged 18 to 56 over the course of a month, looking at how often they masturbated and the motivations behind the solo sessions. On average, each woman pleasured themselves 9 times across a 30-day period, or about twice per week. Yeah. So they reported high levels of stress that were more likely to masturbate more frequently. So according to the women in our study, masturbation serves as a strategy to induce positive emotions and promote relaxation when experiencing stress, one of the researchers had indicated.
Oh.
These findings are consistent with previous research that highlighted the role of masturbation as a coping strategy for psychological stress and a means of relaxation. According to the study, 64% of the surveyed women said they masturbated as stress release, while just 55 said solo play evoked feelings of joy. For me, it's a valve to relieve stress, one of the women wrote. I noticed that I masturbate more often during exam period.
Okay.
Distracts and relieves stress. Distraction and leaves me far less stressed. So there it is.
Twice a week, really?
Twice a week.
Are they also having sex?
No, just straight up masturbation.
Okay.
Yeah.
But they're not having sex with a partner?
No.
At all?
I don't know. It doesn't say that, but it just says why they do it, and they do it twice a week.
Okay.
Which is, I don't know how often everybody else does it. And again, I'm not a woman, but
sometimes
I'd say mine's
like
a daily.
Bitch.
I'm a daily.
We know. We know.
It's a good thing to do before you go to bed. Clean out the pipes. That's how I roll.
Well, the fap and nap, bro.
Yeah. Yeah. So there's
that's a lot.
I don't know. You think it's a lot?
Yeah.
For twice a week?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. I don't do it twice a week.
Holy man.
Seems like a lot.
I don't know. Maybe I'm just weird.
You are.
There's another.
You don't need to wonder about that. I will confirm.
Staying on the stress tip and the studies.
Hold on. No, we're not done with this.
All right. This kind of goes
really good.
We're
definitely not done with this. Do you use it as a stress relief?
Yes.
Oh.
Yep.
Weird. I do not equate the two.
So
I'm not like, I'm feeling stressed. I should probably masturbate. That's not a thing that's happening.
I think
I'm all like, my bitch sent me some pictures. I'm probably going to go to the bathroom and rub one out real quick.
Yeah. I mean, that's, again, I maybe it's tied into it. Maybe, you know, you get the feelings. You're like, oh, this is going to make me feel better, too. You know, I don't know. Mine's just because I can't handle it. I don't know how I still have the libido of a damn 16-year-old.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Like, if I'm under stress, the last thing I am is horny.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Nah, I see that. If it depends on what the stress is.
Yeah. If I'm under stress, that's no.
Yeah, what kind of stress? Because it didn't say that it was like, I mean, obviously the only example that they gave was like during exam times.
Yeah.
Which obviously means that it wasn't the 56-year-old that they had.
Or well,
maybe it was.
She can go back to school. You know,
maybe.
Damn.
But yeah, I don't think it's, I thought twice a week would, maybe it is a lot. I don't know. I don't know how often they do. I'm never around or never asked anybody. It's always like kind of a,
I don't know.
I'm the only one that's dumb enough to sit there and tell everybody how often I do.
Yeah, every day is a lot.
Well, you'd think twice a day sometimes.
My God.
Yeah, I can't. It's horrible. I'll murder a bottle of lotion in like
good
2 weeks.
You're so well moisturized.
Oh, yeah. Everything else, you know, everything else of me looks 45, but my ding dong looks like it's in its 30s still. You know, you got to move the circumference of the moisturization all over the body, not just in one area. Oh, Jergens.
Right. This is a nice sponsorship. All right. What's next?
So there's another one. It's to go along with this about stress, right? So stress in your 20s could cause early cognitive decline during your middle ages, which is probably where I'm at.
Hold on. Let's see. Hello, JJO.
You know, pretty lady, after 20 years, maybe I owe Johnny an apology because it's Monday morning and we're still talking about wieners. I always thought it was just Johnny talking about this stuff.
No, dude. Yeah. Never, it never goes away. Hello, JJO.
Lance has the smoothest right hand.
It does. It looks all young, you know?
It's like in, what was that, Of Mice and Men, when the dude keeps the glove with the Vaseline in it. So
oh, yeah.
He's got the soft hand for his wife. Hello, JJO.
If I use masturbation as a stress relief, I'd paint the ceiling in a week.
You better get on. No kidding.
You'll also paint the back of your hand white, too.
God. Hello, JJO.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Yeah. 2 times a week, that's not enough. That's a daily thing. Sometimes 3 times a day.
Yeah, oh, there you go. God. See, I have a filler.
All right, maybe I need to.
It might be the dudes, too.
Yeah.
Because we can't sit there and stare at yoga pants ever since that invention.
Yeah.
It's jumped up a notch.
I guess. I don't know. Well, maybe I'm doing it wrong. But I'm not. I don't feel like I'm super stressed out either. I feel like I'm pretty zen.
Yeah.
You know?
And that includes, you know, banging, too. I mean, that's.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming that I don't know if this study said it was that's solo what they were doing.
Yeah.
They didn't say they were married or if they were with a partner or anything.
Yeah.
Like that. That's just flat out across the board, just twice a week.
Well, next time I'm feeling stressed out, I'm going to be like, all right.
Try it out. Give it a try.
I don't know. Slap it around. Slap the flaps, dude.
Oh, yeah. And mine's, it doesn't matter. I'm doing it anyway. So,
right.
You know, if I might be just doing it stressed and I don't know. I don't think it relieves stress. And if it does, it does relieve headaches for like a short period of time.
Yeah. Because it increases blood flow.
Yeah. So then it's like, that's the only time I've ever felt that. Like if you're hungover or something like that, that can help.
Man. God, I'm so not.
Well, I know. I don't feel like, but some reason.
When I'm hungover, I'm just not feeling horny either.
No.
All right. Anyway.
Well, anyway, yeah. So I'll give you another.
It's a lot of sharing in a Monday.
Yeah, right. So I was telling you about the stress in your 20s can lead to early cognitive in your middle ages. They did a research at the University of California, San Francisco, and uncovered a startling link between inflammation in young adulthood and cognitive decline during the middle age.
Yeah, stress is bad. Okay.
This discovery could reshape our understanding of the brain health and dementia prevention and suggesting that the choices that we make in our youth may be far-reaching consequences for our mental acuity during later years.
Mm-hmm.
Imagine your brain is a high-performance engine, just as a car.
I'm going to go that far.
Mine's like a... Oh, yeah, right? Mine's like a gremlin or something. I got a Pinto for a brain.
Mine's like a moped, dude. Come on.
Just as the car engine requires proper maintenance from the start to ensure its peak performance over time, our brains need the similar care, beginning with our young adulthood. The study published in the Neurology suggests that allowing inflammation to persist in our younger years could be akin to neglecting regular oil changes. Damage might not be immediately apparent, but it could lead to significant problems down the road. We know from long-term studies of brain changes leading to Alzheimer's disease and other dementias may take decades to develop. One of those doctors had said, in the media release, we see in health and lifestyle habits in early adulthood play a part in cognitive skills in midlife, which is turning it influence the likelihood of dementia in later life. So you got to tell your kids to chill out, you know. Don't sweat the small stuff. You're still alive.
Mm-hmm.
I had a problem with that, and I do still. I always take, and I don't know if it's just how I look at things, and I just all of a sudden it's like a scapegoat, whatever that situation is, of all the problems I have. So I look at something, I'm like, oh, my God, and I think of one situation is worse than it actually is.
Yeah.
Or if I'm just. It's all the culmination of all these different things.
It's your anxiety, bro.
Yeah. I know that. Anxiety is a biatch.
Yeah. You've got it bad.
I know. It sucks.
You know, try explaining anxiety to danger. It's the funnest game on the
planet. Well, when you don't do anything, I guess, besides golf and drink.
I know.
Where's your stress?
Right. I was like, dude, like you literally have no responsibilities after the show. So, yeah. Like.
You just, I got to worry about my biceps.
I know.
Rolling my shirts.
It's like the rest of us have things to do throughout the day.
Exactly.
Jesus Christ.
Try to. Oh, that's JJ News.
He's like, just don't worry about it, dude. Just don't worry about it. I was like, yeah. Oh, yeah. My God. Look at you carrying anxiety.
It's a chemical release, man. You don't even know that? Just don't worry about it. I'm going to be on my third vacation. Don't worry. Don't. Everything's going to be fine.
Don't get me started. Oh, my God.
Nothing's wrong. Yeah, there you go. I signed off already.
I know you did. I actually listen when people talk, believe it or not. It's a thing. It's a whole skill set.
Several times.
It's a whole skill set.
Yeah, I've signed off about three times, bud.
Yeah.
Are we done here? That's what he does. I'm like, yeah.
Oh, man.
We thought uploading to the cloud was something completely different. The JJO Morning Show Podcast. Johnny and D, JJO.
41-year-old South Carolina man was killed after igniting a large firework on the top of his head at a 4th of July block party on Thursday night. He was just trying to show off. Call this Darwinism, I believe. When deputies arrived at a neighborhood block party at 10:23 p.m., they found a man lying in the roadway suffering from major head injuries. Who would have thought? Oh my God!
So what my guess is, what I pictured in my head was the Roman candle ones, you know, or whatever that is.
I don't think so.
Where it just, you know, you have the base and it sits, stands up, and it's just shooting out the top.
It doesn't say what type of firework.
That's what I'm picturing.
It doesn't say, but dumb. The coroner later said the victim, 41-year-old Alan Ray McGrew, ignited a large firework. That's not a large firework.
No.
So I'm going to say it's a different one. On top of his head, he was wearing a large top hat. I saw what he was wearing. It's a stupid Uncle Sam outfit.
So, wait. I mean, those things can be big if they're like the tall standing ones. Depends on how, you know, those big giant thickies that have the base on them. I wonder if, because I think they pop and explode.
Well, it didn't go very well for him. He put the firework on top of the hat before lighting it, and the device exploded, causing massive head injuries.
Oh, boy, I wonder.
Pronounced dead at the scene. According to a report from the sheriff's office, the victim's wife told deputies she believed he placed the firework on top of his head to show off at the block party. How'd that work out for you?
Oh, boy.
Family members tried to get him to stop, but the firework went off, and dude died. So... there you go.
South Carolina.
Hold my beer. Watch this.
Yep. Oh, man. And they have video of him kind of just...
dancing around.
He's doing finger guns for a little bit.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And then he's just dancing, just doing that little white dude bob.
Yeah.
And his,
that was well before.
That was, yeah, it was earlier.
Yeah.
So so he was... how much alcohol was involved here?
Yeah, because he had alcohol in that video.
Yeah, I could see it.
Yeah, 100%.
He was definitely pounding some booze before that happened. He had the cigarette in his mouth.
And his Uncle Sam outfit.
With the beard, the white beard under his chin.
Yeah.
And the big top hat that had the American flag on it.
Mm-hmm.
And the
undoubtedly made in China.
Overalls.
China.
Oh, that sucks. He's just trying to, dude. Part of me is like, feels bad for like the family and stuff like that. I do. I'm a changed man. I feel bad for, you know, he's just trying to mess around. It's better than people that go jumping on the side of those buildings. I don't feel bad for them. You know, at least he was.
How is this different?
Because,
than those people that go jumping on the side of buildings?
The difference is they knowingly go up with the risk that is way higher, right?
And this you dude have knowingly place right. a firework on his head.
Right. I don't think he realized it was going to go back down. Maybe it exploded and it had a, you know, I don't know how it works. So I can't say, but I feel like it went through the bottom when it's supposed to be on the ground. you know? So it probably went back down the other way.
Answer me this. Are you supposed to light fireworks off of your head?
No.
Right.
But have you done it? Not off your head, but have you held a firework and shot it off?
No, you want to know why?
Well, I'm not an idiot. Well, I do bottle rockets. That's a little bit less.
No, I don't. You want to know why? I'm not an idiot. And I would like to keep all of my fingers.
I remember when you did like the Steve-O and you had the bottle rocket in your butt and you shot it out. I remember that.
You were so dumb. You were so dumb. All right. Juveniles who couldn't wait until the 4th of July suspected of using a firework to blow up a porta potty near a lake in Nebraska. It happened on Tuesday night. Witnesses say they heard the explosion and that juveniles drove off in an SUV. Not the gosh darn juveniles.
No, boy.
Blowing up a goddamn porta potty.
Sounded like me in the bathroom.
No kidding, right? After a hot dog. About $900 in damage. So, yeah, porta potty is not cheap, man.
Yeah, what the hell?
Not cheap.
What the hell did they use to blow that up, though?
An unknown firework, they
say. It's got to be like a little bit of the TNT in there, like maybe a tiny little bit of it.
Mm-hmm.
Because there's no way it's going to blow up something like that. You can't do that with some little M80.
Danny Trejo got into a fight at a 4th of July parade after him and his friends got hit with water balloons.
Oh, boy.
They jumped out of their lowrider, and it was on. What you don't want to see is Danny Trejo, 80 years old, jumping out of his lowrider and coming at you with his fists. Here's Danny and one of his buddies commenting on it after it all went down.
I'm so sad that I behaved the way I behaved. I'm so sad that grown men got to throw water balloons. I don't think I would have even got out of the car if somebody hadn't yelled, "It's acid." I immediately got out to look at the hood, and then when I got out of the car, I looked, boom, then a balloon hit me, and then I looked up and I see a guy. I don't know, what in the hell is wrong with you? So when he grabbed me, I stepped back and I fell off the curb. I'm sad.
Good.
I'm just sad that there's still people like from the 50s and 60s that still feel the same way because no one else was targeted.
Come on, you got a classic lowrider in a parade. Yeah. That's the last thing you want is to get water on it.
I would be embarrassed if I attacked an 80-year-old man and he's still talking and laughing.
Did you say acid?
Yeah.
It looks like that ship sailed a long way, long time ago. Looks like it hit him in the face.
Oh, yeah. That would be scary, though.
Yeah. If somebody, why would they yell acid, though?
Well, that, if you thought it was acid in there, that's terrible.
Oh, that's different.
And there were those, people were getting attacked with acid in London for a while there. That was scary.
Oh, dude, what the hell?
Yeah, dude.
Yeah, that's not good.
Buddy got some bruised eye, red swollen arms. Oh, no, not red swollen arms.
Is that him? That's not him.
It's his buddy.
Oh, dude.
Law enforcement told TMZ. Then a radio call came in about a big fight. But by the time they arrived, the crowd had already dispersed, so no arrests were made. Danny said that the people were cowards. That is the end.
Surprised they just didn't pee in them and throw them.
I don't know why you'd be tossing friggin' water balloons at Danny Trejo. He's pretty cool.
For content.
Oh, no.
You know that's what it is. Now they can't release it because they'll just go to jail.
Man, I follow this account on Instagram. It's Influencers in the Wild.
Oh, dude.
And it'll be like...
Tell me it's the one where they go get too close to animals and then...
It'll just be... It's people witnessing influencers filming.
Yeah, yeah.
And it looks super stupid.
Oh, okay.
It's pretty funny.
That's awesome. So they'll just film them doing all their dumb...
Yeah.
Holding their hand out and talking to nobody.
Or whatever, yeah. Yeah, it's pretty...
Yeah,
pretty
it does funny. Look stupid when you're doing that.
Yeah.
If somebody sees you, like, doing all the dancey stuff and you have a, you know, just arm extended.
Right. Or your little tripod.
Or stick. I don't even know if they use the sticks anymore.
I know. What happened to the selfie stick?
I don't know. I see people jumping off buildings with it, you know?
Uh-huh.
They hold it out. Or that one guy that jumped into the shark-infested water.
Here we're back to sharks.
Shark Week. What do you want from me?
It always comes to sharks, man.
Yeah, it's Shark Week.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and Dee, nowhere but JJO.